welcome to another video. Today I am bringing you another tech review, and this time I will be talking to you about the wireless Bluetooth headphones from JBL. This model is Tune 120 TWS, which I have no idea what any of the letters or numbers mean, but I'm gonna proceed anyway. So the first thing I want to talk about is the way they feel, like the build quality and materials. So the case seems very sturdy and it closes with a magnet, so it's very secure. It won't be opening on its own for sure. It's plastic, but it's like very good sturdy plastic, at least that's how it feels. To charge it, the port is hidden behind a rubber sort of, I don't know how you call it, but you know what I mean. And yeah, it feels very good quality. And then the earpieces themselves look good. They come with three different sizes for the rubber that goes on top of them to put them in your ears. I don't know if there's a name for them. But yeah, they look good and they feel good quality. And a really cool thing about the case is that there's some sort of magnet in it. And say this is the right-hand side earpiece. It clicks onto the box magnetically, and then if you try to put them in the wrong hole, the magnet repels it. They do have some buttons on them. They are not touch controls, so you just press on this bit of the earpiece. They do things like pause, play, switch to the next song, and you can also accept calls, and you can switch them on and off or sync them. So there are different controls. You get a nice booklet with the earpieces so you can see exactly what to click and how long for and how many times to do what you want to do. And if you forget which earpiece controls what, you actually have little symbols on the case on each side so that you can easily see what you can do with each earpiece. Another thing about the build itself is that on the case you've got three lights, and they show you how much battery you've got left in the case, and then if it's low, one of the dots will just start flashing. And then you've also got colored lights on the actual earpieces, and they mean different colors. For example, if they are pairing with a device or if they are low battery. When it comes to sound quality, for example, the iPhones headphones that come with your phone, like just the basic ones, well, not anymore, Apple's tight now and they don't give you earphones for free, but anyway, if you've got them, I think the sound quality is slightly better on those than these, but it's good enough, it's good quality. I'm not complaining, I'm not saying it's bad, it's just in comparison, but then I'm very picky about it, so you may not notice, you may think these are amazing. When it comes to battery, JBL promises 4 hours on the earpieces, and then apparently there's 12 hours in the actual box, so in total you get 16 hours. In practice, I have not measured like exactly how long it takes for me to need to charge them, but since I got them at Christmas, I've charged the box twice now, and I've been using them almost every day, anything from half an hour to maybe 2 hours on one use, and they never died on me. It may have been longer, like if I'm just listening to the music or watching something, you know sometimes you just do it for half an hour, sometimes you do it for 2 or 3 hours. The battery is really good, so I think it may be close to what they promise you on the box. And then again, after I use them, I put them back in the box and then they charge automatically, so they are always fully charged when you want to use them. If they last like 2 or 3 weeks of moderate use, I think that's amazing. And if you went somewhere, I don't know, traveling, and you were on a plane for a long time or the train, they would not let you down. Another thing I think I need to mention is how easy it is to connect them. And it's very easy. Once you take them out and put them in your ear, they kind of give you the sound to like let you know that they are on. So they automatically come on. And then you just go on your phone, find them on the Bluetooth settings and just connect. And once they connect, you get like a click in both earpieces. So it's very interactive, sort of the way they let you know that they've connected to a device or they are searching for a device. And the lights also flash or change colors depending on what's happening. If you leave Bluetooth on your phone on and you put them back in the box and then take them out again, they will automatically connect. So I think that's very great and convenient. What I struggled with a little bit is connecting them to my MacBook. It just takes a bit longer to connect. They do connect and it's fine, but a couple of times they were out of sync, so they connected to the Mac and then one earpiece was not in sync with the other, so they would just not play at the same time. It was a bit weird, but there's actually a solution for that. So if you click the button 3 times, they will automatically pair and sort of that will be solved. I had to then switch Bluetooth on and off on the MacBook and then it was fine. And I feel like the sound is a bit behind when you're watching something. I only experienced this on my MacBook. It's very vague though, and you can get used to it and not know notice after you like a few minutes into watching something, you're fine. And the last thing I want to talk to you about is whether I like them, and I would say they are definitely worth it, and they change the way you listen to things and watch things. Because from my experience, I would sometimes sit at my desk at home and watch something or do some crafts and listen to music, and I need to leave my desk and grab something from a shelf or get up and put my lamp on or something like that. You don't want to disconnect from your music or whatever you do, you're watching or listening to, and that is so convenient that I can just get up and not worry about the wires. And it's also very convenient for when you're lying in bed watching something before you go to sleep and you're holding your phone and there's no cable around and it's not sticking out before your phone, it's not in the way. And then lastly, there's no wires to untangle. Every time you want to get your headphones out, pop them out of the box, think, don't. There's actually a physics law to explain it. If you get a form that has two ends, they will tangle themselves always. Like, I don't remember what it's called, but I watched some documentary about it. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching it, and especially if you made it to the end, don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed it and subscribe so that you don't miss any of my new videos. Let me know in the comments below what are your thoughts on wireless headphones, and if you have any questions about these particular ones, feel free to ask it in comments and I'll try my best to answer your questions. Thanks for watching again, and hopefully I'll see you in the next video. Oh my god, it's proper snowing now, thick snow. Ah.